Meeting to order at this time. First item on the agenda is the pledge of allegiance. Darren, will you do that?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Patty just reminded me, you know, she wasn't able to be here last month. She had a little battle with a bug, and the bug was getting the best of her. And she just mentioned that that's the first fiscal court meeting she's missed in 26 years. That's great attendance. Great attendance, Patty. And I'm sure that's probably the reason that one of our money guys here in the stands tonight that's going to go over a budget after a while.
Yeah.
He probably didn't want to come talk to us if he wasn't around.
That's right.
He probably don't know where everything's at.
Did everybody bring their copy of the budget? I didn't put it in. I made a copy of the agenda. I believe it's not the agenda, but the audit.
Next item is the approval of minutes of the March 13th meeting. You have those minutes before you, or is there anything to be discussed about the minutes, changes, amendments?
Move to approve as presented.
Motion to approve the minutes as approved, or as presented.
Second.
Seconded by the Commissioner from District 1, Kathy Adams. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Next item is the approval of the monthly bills. You have those bills before you, and accept some that you guys get to see the ones come in.
Yeah.
Okay. We have a few that came in after the button. The agenda had been established. Any discussion on the bills? Is there anything of any magnitude, Addie? Any extraordinary things? Okay. Any other comments about the bills?
No, about as usual, Judge.
Okay. Not motions in order to approve the bills?
Salute.
Motion by Commissioner Gamble. Any other discussion? All right, need a second.
Second.
Second by Paul. Any other discussion? Not all in favor, signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Next item is transfer to the fiscal court. This is, again, our monthly transfer involving the jail fund. We transfer $40,000 from general fund to the jail fund. I'll forego my speech about the jail fund in the interest of time. So what's the motion? I pledge the court on the transfer.
Make a motion to do the transfer from the jail to the jail.
Motion by Commissioner Adams.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Gamble. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Like sign. Motion carries. Next item. Every year we have responsibility to undergo an audit of our books. Sometimes the state auditor's office will perform that task for us, and sometimes because of lack of personnel, I guess, in Frankfurt at the state auditor's office, they will authorize us to go outside and hire a pre-approved CPA firm to do that audit. And we've had a very long history with Wells & Company. I know when I was my first audit here that we were able to get Wells & Company. And they have been an integral part of our process for a long time. They're local. they're familiar with the system and how we do things here, and we're familiar with how they want things done, just like the auditors of the state auditor's office. And when this audit is finished, it goes to the state audit. They review it, approve it, and then send it back to us, and then we open it, we accept it for the public's benefit. Tonight, we have with us Daryl Blair, and Daryl, I think, wants to come up and kind of tell us where we are and how we got there and what kind of shape we're in.
Yeah, my name is Daryl Blair, and I'm here to present the audit of the Johnson County Fiscal Court for the fiscal year ending June 30th, 2016. I don't know if any of you guys have got your audit reports, but if you do, turn the third page over to the executive summary. We have issued an unmodified opinion based on the audit of the statement of receipts, disbursements, and changes in fund balances, regulatory basis of Johnson County Fiscal Court. In accordance with Title II U.S. Code of Federal Regulations, CFR 200, Uniform Administrative Requirements, Cost Principles, and Audit Requirements for Federal Awards. We have also issued an unmodified opinion on the compliance requirements that are applicable to Johnson County Fiscal Court's major federal program, 97.036, Disaster Grants, Public Assistance, Presidentially Declared Disasters. The financial condition. The Johnson County Fiscal Court had total receipts $9,234,761 and total disbursements of $8,249,709 in fiscal year 2016. This resulted in a total ending fund balance of $4,639,954, which is an increase of $1,131,286 from the prior year. Deposits. The fiscal court's deposits were insured by the bank, securities, or bonds. If you guys would, turn over to page number 6. This here is your statement of receipts, disbursements, and changes in fund balance, regulatory basis for the year ending June 30th, 2016. I won't go over your general fund because all your other funds are restricted for a specific purpose and only allowed to be spent on certain items. General fund is unrestricted, which means you can spend them at your discretion. General fund had total receipts coming in for the year $4,727,451. Had total disbursements going out $4,052,847. For excess of receipts over disbursements before adjustments to cash or uses, $674,604. We had other adjustments to cash and uses. Payroll revolving account had $146,234. Transfers to other funds, $360,000. For total adjustments to cash and uses, you actually used $213,766. Which gives us a net change in fund balance, $460,838 to the good. We got our beginning fund balance from the prior year, $645,982, for an overall ending fund balance, $1,106,820. Bank balance, general fund, we had $1,158,116 less outstanding checks. The $51,296 gives us fund balance ending $1,106,820. Now, I would like to commend the fiscal court because there were no audit findings during our audit, and you were able to increase your overall fund balance in the general fund by $460,838. Now, many counties out there are struggling due to the decrease in state funding and increase in overall costs. You guys seem to have recognized that concern and have taken actions and put the appropriate necessary steps in place to keep afloat. So I just strongly recommend keep on doing what you're doing because it seems to be working, and just keep up the good work. Any questions?
Daryl, I want to say thank you, first of all, for those comments. It's not easy, obviously, to run a local government in this day and time when revenues are going down, and a lot of funding we used to get from Frankfurt is not there anymore. A lot of it's been redirected, and it gets tougher and tougher and tougher every year. And I commend Addie, obviously, and Betty, and the good job they do with the finances and the court by their good stewardship. And they're very much involved in this process. And appreciate the fact that I'm listening to you. Would you say that's a clean audit, is it?
Yeah, there's no findings.
That's what I thought.
And I don't give too many of those out.
That's what I was going to say. You know, you come up here all the time, you don't say that very much. But is this two years in a row?
2 years in a row.
2 years in a row. That's unheard of. Again, I give all the credit in the world to my staff and office staff and the court here for what they do. I think Johnson County has been lucky in a lot of ways. You know, we're like a lot of other counties. We have our bumps and bruises and stump our toe every now and then, but in almost all cases, you look around at the people, the caliber of people, and the integrity of a lot of the people that's filling elected officials' jobs nowadays. Sally Ann does a wonderful job with her office. Mike is trying to balance a whole variety of stuff in his office. And our road foreman is doing a wonderful job. Everybody's working together, I guess is what I meant to say. And we appreciate that so much and appreciate the work you guys do. And having said that, if anybody else has got any questions, go ahead and feel free to ask. If not, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mayor, we appreciate it. Next item is the, do I need to accept this?
Yes.
Just accept it, okay. Any motion to accept the audit? Motion by Commissioner Adams.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Daniel. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Next item is the rural aid contract. That is an MOA that we sign every year with the Transportation Cabinet in Frankfurt. The Commissioner of Rural Road and Municipal Aid, Gary Reese, and his staff, every year the State Transportation Cabinet calculates road aid money by a formula they use. I think they call it the 5/5 formula. And there's five different items, I think, that they look at, and all of it mostly comes from motor fuels tax and things of that nature. And it's formulated to go back to the counties, all the counties, and some of it goes to the cities. I don't know how much, because I'm not involved in that end of the process. But it's a godsend to small counties like us, because it is a large amount of money, and through a series of belt tightening and very good management, I think Sam Oxford and his group down at the road department do an outstanding job. I know Sam, he's not a miser, I don't think, by the definition that a lot of people have. Let me just say that he's thrifty. Sam doesn't spend money that doesn't need to be spent. And he's very good he has a preventive maintenance program. A lot of the trucks and equipment that we buy, they take care of that equipment. We don't have to spend a ton of money repairing them. So he does a great job in his own right down there. This year's road aid money that we're going to get from Frankfurt amounts to $989,970. And that's pretty close to $1 million, as you can see. That's the apportionment. And it is, I think, dished out. We will get the first 60% in August, isn't it, Addie, or somewhere?
Yes.
So we'll get 60% of that $989,000, I believe, in August. And then after the first of the year, we get the next 30. And then the next time we get...
3%. The 3%.
Yeah, we get... but it's, I think they keep back, they peel off for that last payment, they keep 3% for an emergency fund.
Yes.
And thank goodness they do that, because that emergency fund goes into funds for a count for Johnson County. And we've been able to use that in the last couple of years to our advantage when we needed money and we didn't have it available anyplace else with that emergency fund. Is for those purposes, and we wrote a letter and asked for consideration and provided all the documentation they asked for, and were able to get money there. So the use of these funds are very strictly controlled. There is a caveat here on item 6 that says the county agrees and certifies that the apportionment will be expended by the county solely for the purpose of construction, reconstruction, and maintenance of county roads. Now that's pretty strong words, and we're bound by those words. I'd like to have a nickel for everybody that's come in my office since I've been here and said, well, I need this done and this done and this done. And when we check and see, we find out it's either not a county road or there's some other disqualifying reason. And when we tell them we can't do that, if it's not specific for maintenance, reconstruction, and construction of county roads, we can't spend the money because it's illegal, and we're not going to do something illegal. That's hard for sometimes for people to understand, but that's a venue that we operate in, and we're going to continue to do it that way. Is there any questions for the, and I have some information I want to talk about here just in a few minutes that's associated to a large degree with the MOA County Road League. Any questions about the County Road League Fund? If not, need a motion to approve the, or authorize me to sign the contract with Rural Municipal and Aid.
So moved.
Motion by Commissioner Daniel.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Adams.
Danner.
Or I'm sorry, Commissioner Gamble. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Next item is an amendment for the Sheriff's Office. Now that amendment for the County Road Aid, there's a resolution that goes with that we'll have to do. So let's do that, and that way we won't have to do it at next month's meeting. I'd like a motion that would authorize me to sign any and all documents, including the resolution, to implement the County Road Aid Fund between Johnson County and the Department of Rural Municipal Aid for the coming year.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Adams.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Daniel. Any further discussion? If not, all in favor signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Next item is a amendment by the Sheriff's Office. I have a motion, or an ordinance rather, related to the annual budget and amendment thereof. County of Johnson has realized unbudgeted receipts from CLEP January through March of $10,503, and an insurance payment of $4,110. Be it ordained by the Fiscal Court of the County of Johnson, Commonwealth of Kentucky, the budget for fiscal year 2016 is amended to increase the receipts of the Johnson County Sheriff's Office 2017 General Fund of $14,000 to include unbudgeted receipts from CLEF of $10,503 and insurance payment of $4,110. Increase that will move into account number 01-5015-103 and 01-5015-340 for deputies with gross salaries, $10,503, and vehicle maintenance and repairs, $4,110. What's the pleasure of the court?
Move to accept the sheriff's department.
Motion to approve the resolution by Commissioner Campbell.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Daniel. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Like sign. Motion carries. Next item on the agenda is an annual item that we do every year. We have an affiliation agreement that we sign each year, which certifies that in participation with our fire departments that do rescue work, and Jerry, what have we got?
We've got two, W.R. Castle, and also, I don't think we had on the agenda, we've got the affiliation agreement for Rock House, Fire Department.
Okay.
So we've got two affiliation agreements that need to get approved.
Yeah, okay. This is Rock House Fire Rescue. It's the exact title, Fire and Rescue, or just Fire Department?
Fire Department Rescue.
Okay.
Fire and Rescue or Rescue Squad, either way.
Okay, and this permits the Rock House and WR group to participate in rescue activities, is that?
Yeah, and probably the main purpose of this is in time when you make a emergency declaration, it officially puts those rescue squads under the management of the fiscal court.
Directly, yeah, directly under that, yeah.
Right. And then there is rescue grants available through the state, and WR has a grant submitted right now. We've not heard from it, but sometimes it provides some additional funding.
Yeah. Okay, do you want these? Can we do both of them in one motion, or do we need separate motions?
Probably two separate motions, I guess.
Okay. You've heard the director, emergency management director's comments on this, and this is something that we've done now for how many years? 20.
Yeah.
So, mission statement is the rescue squad, which is the rescue squad for these fire departments, shall serve the citizens of the local government by providing fully trained and equipped personnel who will take the lead role in the following types of missions: ground search and rescue for missing or lost persons, extrication of injured vehicles from victims from vehicles and planes, rescue of injured victims and recovery of bodies. A rescue squad will respond and assist, but not take the lead role in the following types of mission: cliff rescue, cave rescue, rescue from boating and electrical rescues, rescue and recovery from still or swift water, evidence search when not related to criminal acts. The rescue squad will not respond to the following types of mission: high angle rescue, search for persons sought for criminal acts, and evidence recovery when related to criminal acts. And you have all the other details that he's provided. I would recommend that we continue to support our fire departments. We've got one of the best first response programs, I think, in the state of Kentucky. We're so lucky to have those kind of people that's dedicated to their job and dedicated to providing safety measures and rescue and first response to all the people of Johnson County by these people that get no money. They're all volunteers, and we owe them a great debt of gratitude. I recommend that we support both these again. I need a motion to accept the Rock House Rescue Squad order of affiliation. Motion by Commissioner Adams. Second by Commissioner Gamble. Any further discussion? Not all in favor, signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Like sign. Motion carries. We have the same identical order of affiliation for W.R. Castle Fire and Rescue. It's verbatim with the other one, so I would recommend that we execute this order of affiliation as well.
So moved.
Motion by Commissioner Gamble. Second by Commissioner Adams. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Harry, you've got your activity report. Is there anything extraordinary?
Only thing I just wanted to update the court on the AFG grant for personal protective equipment that Regina Dunn had. Seven fire departments participating, which was 119 sets of personal protective gear at a cost of around $279,000. All of that, the company's been here, they measured, all the PPE has been ordered, and hopefully we'll have that in maybe within the next 6 to 8 weeks. And then of course that'll be federal funds that'll be transferred down. And of course West Family Fire Department was the lead agency. We had to have a lead department of the seven, so the money will flow through their department. And of course each department has a 5% match, you know, for that. So each department will submit their match money, and then we'll get the federal funds in, and then the checks will be written to the vendor. So hopefully within 2 to 3 months at the longest, we'll have that grant complete. And the Rock House generator has been completed, that project. I think they've got one other little, maybe some safety training or some guidelines for the generator to go on with the guys, but it's been installed, tested, and it's operational now.
Anybody got any comments? Hey, I appreciate what both you guys do to contribute to the safety and welfare and quality of life for the people in Johnson County. I know you do, you wear several hats and try to do a balancing act between all the fire departments and first responders. We appreciate that, and Regina's been invaluable working with all the, and not just Johnson County, I guess you do some of this stuff in other counties as well. But I know City of Paintsville and Johnson County, both owe you a great deal of gratitude for what you've done. You've been able to deliver literally thousands and even millions of dollars over the years in equipment and things of that nature. So thank you both for your contributions to the community.
This is one of the larger grants you've done for the fire department, isn't it, Virginia?
Yep. Well, Paintsville's fire truck was larger in amount.
This contributed, went, divided among seven departments, is it?
Yes.
Okay, thanks so much for what you do, guys. Next item, I want to confirm a personnel action. We had a vacancy at the road department last week, and Sam called and wanted to know if he could, he had a guy that was ready to go, was skilled labor, and we're working down there with a shorter crew than what we've had in the past. But this was a vacancy that Sam wanted to fill. It was, it's for skilled labor. And we always try to hire people with multiple qualifications, and this young man also has a Class D, I think, license, so he can work driving a truck as well as doing the laboring work and helping with the road crews. His name is Benny Montgomery, and at this time I would ask the court to confirm the action of hiring Mr. Montgomery at the road department in the position of skilled labor at the rate of pay that's shown in our policy manual.
Move to approve.
Motion by Commissioner Daniel. Second by Commissioner Gamble. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
What was his first name?
Benny Montgomery.
Bing?
Benny Montgomery.
Oh, Benny, okay.
And I mentioned a little while ago about the county road aid money and how we try to manage these dollars, and Darrell is complimenting us on what we're doing and how we're able to do it when a lot of local governments can't. I don't know how much longer we can continue. As we've said before, and I've told the court before, we're getting by, but I can tell you, it takes a sharp pencil sometimes, and we're about to run up on a wall here, and Addie kind of gets scared about every month that something's going to happen catastrophic. It's going to cost a lot of money that we won't be able to handle. So it's difficult to sit here and worry about the budget dollars and just hope that everything goes okay and you don't get caught in something that's unexpected. I got some really good news here for the people of Johnson County. In spite of the serious economic constraints that all of us, the local governments, face, involving lack of money and revenues, we're doing better than most, as Darrell had told you. And I think it's the attention, as I said before, of the court and their attention to detail, if you will, that it makes it able for us to do what I'm about to announce here. There's three things that I want to talk to you about. I'm pleased to report that I've been working with Frankfurt for the last, I don't know, 2 or 3 months or so. We have a bridge at Hale Road, H-A-L-E, Hale Road, up off 1750 at Hager Hill. It's a road that goes down over the hill just before you get to Conley Record Service. There's a bridge that's been up there for, gosh, I don't know how many years, probably 40 or 50. I don't even know who built it. I don't think the county did originally. But it has been adopted into the system, and there's 15 families, I think, that lives up there. And we've sought for, and we have been advised, that I asked permission from Frankfurt if they would consider, they have a program called an 80-20, which is an 80% program for bridges that they pay for and 20% that we pay for. And this bridge is going to cost about $120,000, $130,000. And if we do the 80-20 split, then the state will be locked in at 80%, or at $80,000. They won't go above $80,000, so we'll have to pick up the extra $35,000 to $40,000, $50,000 to build this bridge. Like I said, it's going to come in at about $120,000 to $130,000. We also, the road foreman has approached me in the last week or so, and I've talked to commissioners about a piece of equipment that we need to, it's very expensive for a mowing machine. If you think of a tractor with a lawnmower with a mowing deck on it, and you know it costs more than probably the machine you're mowing your grass with, but sometimes those things are limited by the things that you can buy, the different components that you can buy to help expedite your project. And we've got a fairly good program going with mowing. We try to mow every single road in Johnson County at least twice a year, and sometimes more if we can. And we need a new mower attachment, which is a larger attachment that makes it possible to get over closer to guardrails and ditches and things of that nature. Costs about $24,000. We found one who's the only supplier that's on the state purchase contract is who we're talking to, so we don't have to bid that. That's a state purchase price. And I've instructed Sam that he should let them know that we're very interested in buying this, and I would ask the court at this time for permission to have him purchase that mower. We'll do that as confirmation of the court, if you would. I'd like to have a motion to that effect, if it's appropriate.
Make that motion.
Motion by Commissioner Adams.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Campbell. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, motion carries. And then back to the road aid money. I told Sam to sit down and let's see what we can do to get the biggest bang for the buck, for our bucks, or limited bucks that we've got in our budget. At the same time, I've been talking to the governor's office since last year. The governor has a fund down there that they call discretionary funding that apparently is handled in the governor's office, and at their discretion, if they have sufficient funding, they may or may not award some of these dollars to counties in the state of Kentucky. We've applied and have been working on it now for quite a while, and I have been advised that we have qualified. I don't have anything signed. I don't have any numbers yet, so I hesitate to say what that would be. But we are looking at funding from the governor's discretionary fund. We're looking at another fund called Flex Funding. And for the court, you guys were here a couple of months ago when transportation engineers out at Staffordville at the Highway Department Maintenance Garage, Tim Spencer, advised that we would have flex money available to us this year in the amount of $103,000. Now, we have not gotten an MOA on that yet, but they've announced that that's what we're getting. So we're going with that number. And there's five roads on that project. There's four roads on the governor's discretionary fund. And then the big list that Sam has put together, and we will do this out of our own budget. And I've been told by Frankfurt and by the rural road aid people that they're not seeing this kind of money anywhere else in the state. And they're asking, how you guys doing this too? Well, we're just watching our pennies, and we got a road department trying to save money, and Sam does a great job on that. So I'd like to announce at this time that in addition to the money for flex money from the state and from governor's flex fund, we have another almost $600,000 for roughly 21 roads, I believe. And do you guys have a copy of these roads? Okay, I'll try to get you a copy. I kind of am reluctant to give you the one that I don't have yet from Frankfurt. We know we're going to do this one, which is the big one, the 600 grand. But when you add all these up, that's getting pretty close to $1 million. That's a little over $800,000. And I'm so pleased. I know the court is pleased that we're able to do that, because this is going to benefit hundreds of families. I don't know exactly how many families live on these 30 roads or several miles of road involved in this, but there's going to be hundreds of people literally out there in the county that's going to have fresh blacktop to drive on, and that's no small chore for them to not have a good road, and it's no small chore for us to be able to find money. I don't know how much longer we can do this, but we're going to continue to try to do as much as we can, and I guess we'll see where that goes. But I do, again, want to publicly thank the court and the staff in our office and the road department for working with us to do the best we can do for the people of Johnson County. Anybody got any comments? If not, I guess we'll, anybody here for the good of the county? If not, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn. Have a motion and a second.
Second.
For adjourn.